Hello everybody, it's me Laura again, and today I'd like to warmly welcome you to some tingly, mosaic creations. In this video today, I will be creating some mosaic themed designs from the items included within this kit. So there are four butterfly designs to choose from that come with foam and crystal accessories, and I will be choosing one or two of these to create for this video today. So feel free to sit back and relax as I create these mosaic designs. So I wanted to begin with a little bit of letter tracing. S T I C K Y sticky M O S A I C S mosaics. B U T T E R F L I E S butterflies. And there are four designs and 2,344 pieces. And these are the designs included within the kit. And it includes 17 different coloured and textured accessories to include on the designs. Okay, so let's have a look at the designs and accessories and choose one of preference. So this is the first design. This is the second design. This is the third design. And this is the final design. So I think I'm going to begin with this particular design. And here are the sheets. That come with the designs. We have pink cubes. We have pink and blue cubes. We have light pink cubes. Yellow cubes. Additional. We have blue glitter. More blue glitter. Neon yellow glitter. Additional. Rosy pink cubes. Additional. Purple cubes. And three sets of white cubes. We also have three sets of white glitter. We have three sets of pink glitter. Three sets of turquoise glitter. Teal color cubes. Purple glitter. Pink glitter. Orange glitter, another orange glitter, and two sets of salmon colored cubes in glitter. So these match up to the numbers on the design. So the first thing that I need to do, I need to check what colours and designs are required for this particular project. So the number 9 is required, and that's orange glitter. Okay. We also need the number 11, and that appears to be plain yellow. So let's grab those. We also need the number 1, which is the white glitter. We also need the number 3, which is the pink glitter. I think it's the light pink glitter. We also need the number 6, which is the dark pink glitter. And the number 8, which is the salmon coloured glitter. We also need the number 2, which is the plain white colour. We also need 17, which is the purple glitter. Are we missing any? See number 10. 10 is the yellow glitter. We need that one. Okay. So if we need any more additional colours, we'll come back to the accessories on the side. So now I'm going to organize the work area so that we may begin. So for this today, I will be using some tweezer style tools to help pick up the items. So that I may apply them to the design. And now, we are ready to begin with the design. So, let's begin with this one right here, which is number 10. Number 10 is the yellow glitter. move on to the number 3, which is the light pink glitter. So I found this kit at a local arts and crafts store, and I loved how it included so many different colours and accessories. And I also love creating content that almost feels like it's unintentional ASMR. So I thought that this might include quite a lot of things that may hopefully relax or tingle you or help you drift off to sleep. This is my first time creating a mosaic design. I happen to be enjoying it so far. Okay. There we go. And if I need to alter the placement of any of the accessories, then I will do so. Proceed with the light pink glitter colour. I love the colours on these, by the way. So now I want to move on to a different colour. Let's go with the number 9. Number 9 is the orange glitter. So if you happen to enjoy this particular video, let me know, and I will create the other designs for you in upcoming videos. quite excited to see how this will turn out. I think it's going to look quite pretty. The last one for that row. Okay. So let's do a couple of nines here before moving on to a different color. Which is the white glitter. Just to put that underneath the orange. And the last one. A couple more up here. And of course you don't have to stick to what the design suggests. You can of course put whatever colours on the butterfly that you want. I'm going to move on to the plain yellow cubes. And I'm going to apply those. They are leaving slight tweezer marks, but that's all. So now I'm going to proceed with a few more of the number nines. Okay. And I think I will fill in this section. So far, I'm really enjoying this. This is quite relaxing to do. And the tweezers are very helpful. And that section is complete. So now I am going to move on to the yellow glitter again. Place that on the number 10 around the edge. I love the colors of these. And I'm just going to go up to the edge of that one. Two more. Okay, so that is that section complete. So now let's move on to the number 8. And number 8 is the salmon glitter color. As you can see right here. I'm going to add in a few of those. Like so. fill in the small number 9 section. Okay, so that is that section complete. So now let's move on to number 7. So the closest color that I could find for number 7 is this one. It's not exactly true to the color provided on the instructions, but it's the closest out of the bunch. Last one for that section. There we go. And now let's move on to number 8. Number 8 is the salmon glitter. Let's add in a few of those. Detail. Two more. The last one. There we go. So now let's move on to section 5, which is the dark pink cubes, which I think I left over here. Okay, just a little check. Okay, let's include a few of those. the last one. Okay, so let's finish off that section now with the dark pink glitter. This color is very pretty. So I'm not sure if you can tell, but I find the circles to be a lot easier to work with than the squares. Okay. Two more. The last one. Okay. Great. And that completes that section. So now we're going to go back to number 7, which is the plain orange cubes. I'm going to include those. Those are placed at more of an angle, so those will be a little bit trickier to place accurately. Next one. Okay. Okay. One more. Last one. Okay. And so now I'm going to carry on with the plain yellow squares just around the edge. This is also angled a little bit tricky. Okay. We need to turn it to make it just a little bit easier. 5 more on that particular part. One is a little bit too far down. Let's make that a little bit more even. Okay. So now I'm going to move it sideways. Going to move that down slightly so I can reach it a little bit easier. Okay, down again. Great. To the next one. Last one goes there. Okay. So that is that particular section complete. So now I'm going to add a few details. The glitter orange. Last one. So now I'm going to move on to the plain white cubes. And I'm just going to finish off that section. Three more. And the last one. Is right there. Great. So now, let's move on to this part. So I need the rosy pink cubes again. Going to include those right there. Number two. Number three. And number four. And so now we are moving on to the glitter circles again to fill in the edge. Two more. Okay. Okay. And so now we're going to move on to number 10 again, which is the yellow glitter. And this has just a few of the yellow. Okay, to the last one. Right there. Okay, great. So now we're moving back to the white cubes. Might need to bring this a little closer. Okay. And the last one for this wing. Right. That. Okay. Well, I think that looks really good so far. So now let's move on to the next wing. So I'm going to begin with the orange glitter circles on the edge. Last one goes right there. So now I'm going to move back to these cubes again for number 7, just right next to that. And number 4. Great. So now we're moving back to the light pink circles, which are going to go right under that. Grab the orange glitter again, just put that right there. One more. Okay. Okay, and that is that particular section complete. And now we're going to move back to the yellow circles. There are quite a few that require this. I'm going to move back to the salmon pink glitter for this section. Last one. Okay. And now I'm going to move back to the yellow glitter circles. Just detail around the edge. Just going to proceed along that edge. Last one, right there. Okay. So now I'm going to move back to number 3, which is the light pink glitter circles. I'm just going to detail those. Last one for that section. Okay. next I'm going to move on to the salmon glitter colour. Just include those above. Is that section complete? Now I'm going to be moving back to the light pink. Like so. Okay, and that is that section complete. So now we're going to move on to the orange glitter. Details. Just going to do a few more of those. I'm just going to move this down so that I can reach. Up in the corner. So now I'm going to move on to number 5, which is the warmer pink colour. I'm just going to place that there. So now we're going to move on to number 6, which is the dark pink glitter. I'm just going to detail down the side. So that is all that is required for that colour. So now let's move back to the yellow squares. To begin on the edge, so now let's move on to the white squares. Two more. Okay. And the last one. Okay. So that is all of the white cubes. So now let's move back to the rose color, and continue with those. Okay. Three more. now going to take that same color and I'm going to work up the edge. And that is that section complete. And now we're going to move back to the orange glitter. And the last one for that section. And now we're going to move back to the salmon colored glitter. Coral. going to fill that in. Last one. Okay. Now we're going to move back to the yellow squares to finish off the edge. Now, I'm just going to finish off this side. We have 6 left of this one. That is the butterfly complete, and now we're going to move on to the flower and the other butterfly. So I'm going to begin by applying the white glitter circles to the butterfly. I'm going to move on to the orange glitter circles. So that is it for the orange and white glitters. Now we're going to move on to the yellow glitter circle. Thank you. is all of the yellow glitter circles required. And now we're going to move back to the light pink circles. And we're going to fill in that area. And that is all of the light pink glitter required. And now we're going to move back to the coral color. So that is all of the coral glitter color required. So now I'm going to move back to the yellow squares to fill in the edge. And the last one. Okay. And that is the second butterfly complete. So now we are going to be moving on to the final design and the final color, which is a color we have not used yet, and that is the purple glitter circles. And this is going to be going on the petals of the flower. Now, the next petal, okay. So that is this particular butterfly mosaic design complete. If you would like to see more mosaic designs, let me know in the comment section below. I'm really happy with how this turned out. I love all of the colours, as well as the glitters and how they complement each other. Thank you so much for watching this video today. Take care, everybody. Goodbye.